Good morning, traders. Matt Weller here, Global Head of Research with Forex.com, welcoming you into a new year. Happy New Year to everyone, and thanks for following. Today is the 2nd of January, 2024, and here's the key news you need to know ahead of today's U.S. session. Frankly, it's fairly quiet in U.S. session trade as many traders are still on their New Year's holidays. Generally speaking, the U.S. dollar is edging higher as we enter the U.S. session. There's no real major economic data on tap until we get into tomorrow when we have Fed minutes and ISM manufacturing, PMI, the JOLTS report. Things will really pick up as we get into tomorrow in terms of volatility. But right now we're watching a tad bit of strength in the U.S. dollar and some weakness in the S&P 500. Indeed, the futures for all U.S. indices are pointing to a slightly lower open. That's very interesting in the context of the S&P 500's 9-week winning streak. This is something we've only seen 13 times over the past 100 years, or about once every 7 years. We see the type of streak that we're currently on in the S&P 500, and that's actually been even more rare of late. We've only seen it happen 3 times in the past 50 years. So a very strong streak in the S&P 500. I'll be writing on Forex.com about what that means for future returns, or at least what it could mean based on history. So do check that out maybe an hour after this video hits the wires. Only other note I wanted to mention is that Chinese composite PMI came in just a tick lower than expected. I think a major theme for the first quarter and maybe for the entirety of 2024 will be the potential for stimulus in the world's second largest economy. In his annual address, President Xi vowed to strengthen the economy and job creation. That was just this weekend ahead of that PMI data. So that'll be a key theme to watch in the near term and potentially throughout the year. Today's chart of the day is the S&P 500, where you can see it pulling back. Notably, we saw what's called a bearish divergence in the 14-day RSI. So on that subpanel, RSI, a measure of momentum, put in a new high in mid-December as the index did, but then it put in a lower high in late December, whereas the index still made a higher high. That indicates fading buying pressure and the potential for a pullback. Key support levels to watch: if we do in fact pull back on the S&P 500, start coming in around the mid-46s and then 4600 even, where we saw previous levels of resistance or ceilings on prices, that could become support or a floor under price moving forward. That is today's video. Thank you for joining me. And if you are catching us on YouTube, please do like the video, subscribe to our channel. It helps us with the algorithms and will keep us doing far more of these videos as we move through the year. Thank you.